I do not see inside this vault. I just see, white light or white space. I can see how the door is made. Many, many, many layers of, I'm going to guess, 3, maybe 4-inch thick steel plates. One plate after another, and each plate got bigger and bigger. I do not see the internal mechanics of the door. The rods and stuff like that. And I only see those outer layers, and it was quite thick. And door shut, and now it goes back to where it was when first doing the model. I only seeing basic colors, but goes back, and I see these people who are in this crawl space above it. That room that led to the shaft. There's this, between the floors, there's this crawl space. Well, I don't know, but there's these people in there, and there's people around the house. They're all trying to get down into that one room that led to that shaft. It seemed something that kept them at bay. And then the dream ends. Then I had one short dream a few days later, I suppose, or a week or so. I'm in an office. There aren't many people around. I don't know what I was doing before, but now I am gathering bottled water. And I'm getting empty water bottles that I've drank from previously and going to the water fountain and filling them up. I'm getting this food, this snacks and stuff you normally find in an office. Well, this one guy, he's there at his desk and look at me a little funny, like, what the hell you're doing? You're acting rather strange. And he goes back to doing his work. See, some kind of, I don't know what kind of business this is. It's just a big old office building, tower, And, and I'm getting myself, I got these keys, and I have all this stuff, put together. I'm about to barricade myself inside this office, this locked office, one of those, for the people who are a little bit higher up on the food chain, I guess, I suppose, in an office setting. They got their own office, locking door, privacy. And the other side, they got all this nice windows, nice view, but I'm barricading myself in one of those offices, and then the dream ends. All these dreams had a common theme. It was about getting to a safe place. It was getting into a place that provided protection or was difficult for others to get to. Okay, I'm now remembering another dream. I'm kind of surprised that I still remember this one, but it was at this big old boarding school. I don't know where it is. I'm only observing at this time. People were different. Something had changed. These kids didn't seem like kids anymore. There wasn't anything like in the first dream to begin with, but they had people killing each other or doing anything like that, but they seemed so strange. It's like, snap one's two fingers, but turn of a dime, they changed, and nobody wanted to go around that place. And I'm there and stuck in this place for some reason, somehow. And I could see in all these different spots in this school and these kids that, I guess, demonic, something really demonic had taken place, and they weren't the same. They didn't attack each other, but they attacked people who were more or less normal. It wasn't like anything in a zombie movie, but it was something odd. And for the moment, in this dream, they were all locked up in the school. big, big school. And one of the prominent things I remember, it was a modern building, but it also had a lot of stonework. Like you would see in Europe or someplace like that, real fancy stonework, rough stone and cut stone. But there's just at the end of the dream, I'm in this huge in-room swimming pool, massive swimming pool, big, real big swimming pool, and it had these rock walls. And above that pool were two causeways or whatever that went over it. And there's these two big old shafts that led up to skylights above it. And one of these big old crosswalks, causeways, whatever you want to call it, these kids were there. And I had to. There was no way to walk from one end to the other in this at this pool. You either had to swim or you simply went through the hallways. Well, the hallways I couldn't get to. And I had to find someone to get to this part of the building that had nobody around. It was safe. So I had to get into the water and swim. As I swam under the first one, I had a lot of dread. I was worried that some of them would jump down, even though it was like a, I guess a 30-foot drop, 30, 40 feet. It's a big room. And I was like, oh God. Gonna jump down and attack, you know. Yeah, I had that feeling, but I swam and nothing happened. I heard this. I started hearing music playing as they crossed, you know, got underneath the second one toward the back of the room. At the back of the room, you can get up out of the water, and there's these doors. And I got to these doors, and the dream ended. It's an interesting dream. Interesting dreams, but it all had that common theme. It was getting to a safe place. Anyway, I'm wondering if anyone has had any dreams like that in the past few months or so. Why, the only part I'm able to understand is that something was either it was chemical or biological, or it was something completely different than that, maybe demonic, that had affected a lot of people in a manner that made them very violent. But at the same time, it's not like, you know, something out of Dawn of the Dead. They weren't all bloody and half-eaten, you know, attacking something else. These people were, you know, it was like a flip of a switch or a butt, you know. It's like something had changed in their head, you know, in their mind. Made them like vicious animals. They didn't attack each other. They attacked normal people instead. They went after animals and attacked them. Wildlife, you know, livestock, they terrified. They just ran. People that weren't affected, they hid.